Newstime, brought to you by Jell-O Desserts.
CKLW Radio International News Alert, Dick Smythe reporting.
Here's a sparkling idea for evening snacks. Serve Jell-O in any one of a dozen different flavors. Jell-O's so cool and colorful, so refreshing, so light and easy to eat. Everyone will enjoy its delightful new fresh fruit taste. Be sure to add Jell-O to your list of standbys for interesting, tasty evening snacks. Why not make some now, so you'll have it handy for your family or guests tonight?
In Michigan this morning, Dr. Albert Hustis, the state health commissioner, wants to hear from newlyweds. As you know, there's a tempest in a test tube over the way certain labs have been administering premarital blood tests. Hustis wants to compile information on the situation. Write him, care of the State Health Department, Lansing. Mayor Donald Somerville of Toronto, elected just last December, is dead. The mayor, only 48, had been playing in a hockey game between city officials and newsmen. He complained of fatigue, went to the dressing room, where he collapsed and died. The Russians, who have been busier arresting Americans than launching spaceships lately, may have something in the works. Don McKay reports for CKLW News.
Fresh reports that Russia is preparing to send rockets to Mars and Venus. For some time, it's been clear that something is brewing, for the Soviets have carried out 5 experimental space launchings since last June, obviously in preparation for more ambitious projects. Now, according to Moscow radio reports monitored here, the latest hint comes from the chief of applied cosmic mechanics at the Moscow Academy of Science. The Moscow official indicated no date for a Soviet shot at Mars, but there have been rumors the Russians may try it within the next couple of months. However, officials here think that the Soviets will probably first try to get a space platform up into orbit to act as a way station for the more ambitious assaults on Venus and Mars, and that the Mars shot will not be for some time yet. This is Don McKay in London.
Here are some of the other items on the CKLW news desk today. Radio 80 rush hour is 9:02. A South African gold mine accident has killed 4 men, injured 13, and trapped 6. A rock fall occurred early today. The communists raised some left-wing havoc in Caracas, Venezuela, yesterday. They're protesting the December 1st election. Had called for a general strike yesterday when no one paid any attention. They set fire, scattered tacks on highways, and went around the city shooting and throwing bombs. No sight of that missing freighter in the Florida Strait. She disappeared yesterday with 9 men aboard. A search out of Key West began at dawn today. Governor Romney has decided to throw in the towel on his ADCU fight. Will seek new legislation that will enable Michigan to participate in the Aid to Dependent Children of the Unemployed program. Romney said the original bill was up to federal requirements. The Democrats, and more importantly, the Health, Education, and Welfare Department in Washington, said it wasn't. Romney addressed the National Municipal League conference last night, defended the new constitution against the attacks of what he called November quarterbacks. And Virginia Douglas, the 74-year-old woman of Yes, Virginia, There Is a Santa Claus fame, said yesterday in Chatham, New York, the post office is out of its cotton-picking mind. Says it's ridiculous to make children put a zip code number on their letters to Santa Claus. By the way, it's 99701. And in that same vein, for the last several months, the Coast Guard in Long Beach, California, has been plagued with distress calls in connection with a 36-foot fishing boat called the Seahawk. It was being towed in for the 6th time last Friday when the line snapped and it disappeared. But yesterday, the Seahawk was spotted floating upside down. The Coast Guard, by this time pretty tired of the whole thing, sank it with the help of several 40-millimeter shells. One free with every 3. Yes, you get one free Jell-O Instant Pudding regular size with every 3 you buy when you take your coupon to the store. Now, if maybe you haven't received a coupon, just print your name and address on the inside of a Jell-O Instant Pudding package front and mail it to CKLW, Windsor, Ontario, and we'll send you one. Use it to buy 3 flavors and get another Jell-O Instant Pudding free. Radio 80 weatherman says cloudy and mild today with rain late this afternoon or tonight, ending Thursday morning, high today 55, low tonight 42, high Thursday 57 degrees. That's the news, and this is Dick Smythe.
Be sure you're never stuck for something different for dessert. Next time you shop, pick up several of the Jell-O family of fine desserts. J-E-L-L-O.
The Radio 80 international temperature is up a degree to 47 as the Bud Davies Show continues.